Former President Donald Trump said this morning that he has almost enough money to post bond, undercutting his lawyer's claims that he would not be able to comply with the $464 million judgment against him in the civil fraud case brought by New York Attorney General Letitia James. He has until Monday to post the bond before James can start seizing his assets. And apparently she's already on the move. But he wrote on Truth Social early this morning, "Through hard work, talent, and luck, I currently have almost $500 million in cash, a substantial amount of which I intended to use in my campaign for president. The often overturned political hack judge on the rigged and corrupt AG case, where I have done nothing wrong, knew this, wanted to take it from me, and that's where and why he came up with the shocking number, which, coupled with his crazy interest demand, is approximately $454 million. That's all one sentence. I did nothing wrong except win an election in 2016 that I wasn't expected to win, did even better in 2020, and now lead by a lot in 2024. This is communism in America." In another post, he described the judgment as so unconstitutional and said, "Judge Arthur Engoron came up with a crazy, out of thin air award in order to damage me politically and not allow me to use any of the large amount of cash I have built up over the years. Through hard work, insight, instinct, and diligence on my political campaign for president." His lawyers have previously said in court, in a court filing on Monday, that he was unable to secure a bond, despite the fact that at a deposition last year, Trump said he had substantially in excess of $400 million in cash. And he's likely about to become much, much richer after it was announced today that his company, Trump Media, would be taken public. Shareholders voted to approve Trump Media's merger with a blank check company following years of legal and regulatory obstacles. Trump will own a dominant stake in a public company with shares worth more than $3 billion at current market prices. But that doesn't mean much with regard to the bond, because he won't be able to monetize his stake right away. Trump's stake will be tied up for much of the year under a so-called lockup agreement, a normal arrangement for such deals to ensure that insiders don't bail as soon as a company goes public and push down the stock price. There's more to this story, but I want to bring you both in. Cenk, what do you make of this? Do you believe him when he says he has the money for it?
Well, I hope it's true. Then this whole thing's solved. As usual, Donald Trump punches himself in the face. So I'm gonna come back to that in a second. I'm gonna come back to, I have the answer for how to solve all this. So rest assured, everybody, take a deep breath. And then my favorite part is the Trump Media asset that he's now theoretically has over $3 billion. I love that, sir. Okay, so one thing at a time. A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us. Number one, you remember back in 2016, Donald Trump claimed that he had $10 billion. Then in 2021, he legally said that he has $4.5 billion. And so if he really has $4.5 billion, you might still have some difficulty getting $500 million in cash, because a lot of people have it locked up in stocks or real estate, et cetera, that's harder to get out. But if you have $4.5 billion, you probably have a $500,000 in cash, as Trump is saying now. But I'd like to make a couple of notes about that. Number one, if you have it, then why are we having this conversation? The law is you're supposed to give it over, and you just said you have it. He's so dumb, he just can't help himself. Why would you say, as you're begging everyone, and your lawyer said on TV, that you might even be asking foreign governments for the money? You have right-wing media begging right-wing billionaires for the money. Why would you say you have it then? You're in court saying you don't have it. And then you publicly say that you do have it. It's Donald Trump's lack of intelligence is immeasurable. He's like negative IQ. And why? Because he can't help himself. He wants to, his whole thing is self-puffery. I'm so rich, I have so much money. And that's a stupid game he's been playing this whole time. Can I ask you guys, if you guys are diehard MAGA, and you think, oh, Cenk, boo, Trump's right about everything. He's such a demigod of truth and honesty. Wait a minute, and he's such an awesome businessman. Let's just think this through, because if Trump is right, and you guys are right, that he always tells the truth, he had $10 billion in 2016, $4.5 billion in 2021. How did this awesome businessman lose $5.5 billion in 5 years? Come on, guys. Anybody who doesn't think Donald Trump is a hilarious liar is so detached from reality, they're hopeless. We just have to talk to the sane people in this world to get to objective reality here. Of course, he doesn't have that kind of money, and of course, he doesn't have the cash. I don't know what he's gonna do here, but I do have what should happen. And right now, this is pretty much in the process of happening. I think that forcing him to sell all the properties now is too draconian. I don't think it's the right thing to do. On the other hand, I think putting liens on the properties, meaning, hey, if you lose the appeal and you go all the way through and you've lost the case, then at least we can seize your properties then. We have the legal right to seize your properties then. That's fair, because he's got to put up the collateral so that we know he can pay this, but without bankrupting him now by making him sell his properties. I'm curious what you guys think about that. Actually, let's talk about that, and I'll save what I think of Trump media in a second, because that is also hilarious, okay? But Trey, what do you think about his claims and what should happen to him in that case?
Well, first of all, I just think it's fun. I think all the time about what it must be like to be one of Donald Trump's lawyers. You know what I mean? Because presumably these people like do their level best and try to be all, you know, stick to the law and present these like seemingly legitimate and legal reasons why we can't comply with that request. And then later that night, Trump, while on the toilet, gets on Truth Social and is like, just so everybody knows, I can totally comply with this request. I'm just not going to, because the judge is a hack and an idiot. And I just want to put that out there. And you know, the lawyer's gonna be sitting there like, Jesus Christ, like it's got to be. So plus you don't get paid and could end up in jail yourself. So not an enviable job, I think. And also, I like this story because it does cut right to the heart of his whole like persona. He is like, you know, a Scrooge McDuck type rich person, or wants everybody to think he is. Like he's a cartoon version of a rich man. And that's how he identifies, and it's very important to him. So like something that hits him in his wallet and makes him appear to not have as much money as, you know, he says he does, I do enjoy. I get a lot of schadenfreude from that. And you know, anything that leads to like headlines about Trump being broke, I'm all for it. I do kind of bristle at that because I come from a long line of broke people. Like I'm from old no money, right? And it's like he's not broke. Like I don't know when's the last time he had to choose between new tires and a fan belt, or like, you know, live off of ramen noodles and beanie weenies. Like he's not broke. He's rich people broke, which is different. Rich people, when they're broke, they can keep playing golf somehow. I don't get how all that works, but. But yeah, I know it's got to be tough for his ego, which is why he can't help but say, no, I totally have it. Because, you know, when he says he's like, I'm the billionest billionaire that ever billioned. You can't admit to not having half of only 1 billion. You know, you have to pretend you have it. But like you guys said, like, if he did, then where is it? What's going, why isn't he, you know, coming forward? Why isn't he actually producing it? So no, I don't think he has it. As far as what should happen, you're a far smarter man than me, Jank, so I'm just gonna defer to your expertise. That, what'd you call it, lanes? Yeah, lanes, that sounds good. I think we should do that. I'm with you.
I don't agree that I'm smarter than you, but I hear what you're saying about the legal options. Jordan.
Yeah.
Well, you know, we talked about the assets earlier, and the deadline to post his bond is on Monday, at which point Letitia James can start claiming assets. According to CNN, she is already on the move. The New York Attorney General's office has filed judgments in Westchester County, the first indication that the state is preparing to try to seize Donald Trump's golf course and private estate north of Manhattan, known as Seven Springs. It doesn't necessarily mean that seizures of the Westchester properties are imminent, but judgments are the initial step James needs to take if she plans to seize them in the future. Judgment has already entered in New York City, where Trump's properties, including Trump Tower, his penthouse at Trump Tower, 40 Wall Street, his hotel abutting Central Park, and numerous apartment buildings are located. Judgments have not been entered yet in Florida, where Mar-a-Lago is located, but some, including Republican pollster and Trump critic Frank Luntz, think Letitia James seizing his properties is a terrible idea. Take a look.
If the New York Attorney General starts to take his homes away, starts to seize his assets, it's all gonna be on camera. Pundits are gonna sit there and scream about this. This man cannot be elected. You're going to create the greatest victimhood of 2024, and you're going to elect Donald Trump. If they take his stuff, he's gonna say that this is proof that the federal government and the establishment and the swamp in Washington and all the politicians across the country and the attorneys generals and all of this, that this is a conspiracy to deny him the presidency. He's going to go up in the polls just like he went up every single time they indicted him. I don't understand. I'm almost speechless in how pathetic the opposition to Trump has been and how completely misguided. And this is a perfect example of it.
So, Cenk, is Frank Luntz right here?
Republican pollster, they're probably the top pollster on their side in my lifetime. But he does not like Donald Trump and does not want him to win. So with that caveat. But look, I've been stunned by how pathetic Trump's opposition is all of this time. I mean, they're so bad at running against him, so bad at holding him accountable. And part of the reason for that I could explain, which is that the Democratic leadership has such an establishment mindset that they cannot relate to the average guy. So they can't see what the average guy was gonna get mad about. And number one thing is that they don't get that the average guy's mad about them, right? And so they keep going in the wrong direction. So, okay, but how does that play into this? Well, if you put liens on his properties as I'm suggesting, you're not actually taking them and selling them now, which has much worse optics. But you have the ability to sell them if he loses the appeal. That is both more fair and will have better optics. But knowing how Democratic establishment groupthink is, and Letitia James is roughly part of that groupthink, and she's being encouraged by other pundits on cable news and other politicians in the Democratic Party, they kind of want that schadenfreude that Trey was talking about. So they want to see his houses taken away. But then he's gonna get to say, look at the communists taking my property. The case isn't even over yet. Yeah, I lost the first round, but I have appeals coming up. And that's gonna resonate with people. And if you sell his properties now, they're gonna be sold in a fire sale. So something that could have gotten $150 million maybe gets $85 million. Well, that money's gone then. The difference, let's say it was round numbers. Could have gone for 150, went for 100. That $50 million, the state can't recover, Trump can't recover, it's gone. So I think it's a really bad idea to sell the properties, both politically and in terms of policy as well. So regrettably, I think Luntz is right. And the Democrats just can't see straight. Anything that attacks Trump, they think is good. But that's not necessarily the case. You have to actually be smarter about how the politics of this plays out. So I do want to go back to the thing that I promised about Trump media. Guys, they say the company now that it looks like it's gonna go forward. I mean, it's perfect that he made a deal with a blank check company. That's exactly the kind of deal that Trump would want to make. That the company itself is going to be worth $6 billion, and that Trump owns 58% of it. That's why he's going to have over $3 billion. That is very unlikely, but there is a narrow window where it is possible. So the stock is hilariously overvalued. I mean, I've never seen a stock more overvalued in my life. This thing's worth $6 billion. It has one asset right now, True Social. Do you know what True Social did in the third quarter of this year or of last year? So that's a quarter of the year. They made $1.1 million in revenue. And that company's worth $6 billion? Hilarious. Hold on, it gets way worse. That's revenue. How about profits? I mean, if you made $1.1 million, you probably don't have that much profits, right? No, way worse. They lost $26 million in one quarter. So he's on pace to lose over $80 million for the year. And that company's worth $6 billion? No, I wanna explain to you guys, and especially if you're MAGA, if you're ever gonna listen to me on anything, this should be it. It's a sucker's play. So they wanna introduce it publicly, have all you guys buy the stock, have it be super overinflated, and within 6 months, management, and perhaps including Donald Trump and the shareholders, can start selling their stock. So they'll sell their stock like crazy and it'll crater. It's not worth anything. It's run by Donald Trump, one of the dumbest people in America. He's gone bankrupt 6 different times. He's almost never succeeded in any business he's ever run, and it's already losing about $80 million a year with no hope of ever turning it around. So the only way he gets any of that money is if they could just hold on for 6 months while MAGA suckers buy the stock and no one else. then the rest of the market will short the crap out of it. It'll collapse so quick and so overwhelmingly. Okay, this is the type of thing that I would bet any money on. Okay, that the chance of that company's survival and turning a profit is zero. It's not near zero, it's zero. So let's see if I'm right or wrong. We'll see. That's the beauty of all this, guys. So Trump says he's got the $500 million. Well, he has to put up the bond on Monday. So we'll find out, won't we? And you'll get to see with your own eyes. And if 10 years from now, you know, Trump media is still running strong and Trump's got billions of dollars from it and he didn't sell the stock, he just owns it and it's doing great, then okay, then you come back and say, ha ha, Jake, you didn't know anything about business and Trump did. But you'll see. All right, any other thoughts, guys?
Yeah, the Trump media thing, I had been wondering what their next like grift was gonna be to like financially exploit his, you know, his base or whatever. And my money had been on commemorative plates. I thought that was a play they were gonna make at some point. You know what I mean? Put Trump's face on a plate like Dale Earnhardt style. Real big in the trailer park. I thought I could have been onto something. But you know, this stock, it also, you know, that works too, I guess. But I mean, obviously you're right. The idea that Truth Social is apparently worth $6 billion. I mean, all this stuff, Wall Street valuations are always, they seem like, you know, like Hogwartsian to me anyway, and rarely ever make any sense. But especially this, yeah, I don't know where they're getting that from. But you know, people are going to line up to buy it. It's definitely going to happen. You know, ain't no grift like a Trump grift, baby. But as far as the lunch thing, I don't know. When I hear people say like, to me, that sounds like them saying he shouldn't face the typical consequences because it will be helpful to him because he'll complain about it. And I'm listening like, so does that mean he's just supposed to get away with everything because of, you know, who he is and how dumb his fans are, because it'll be interpreted as like the government coming after him and it might help him out. That means that what? He should just be allowed to keep things that anyone else in his position wouldn't be able to keep? I don't know. I'm too law dumb to really speculate on it. But yeah, and the last thing on the stock, I do think it's kind of appropriate that artificially inflating the value of something is, you know, he's right back to doing that again. It's like, that's how we got here in the first place. So time is a flat circle. What are you going to do?
You know, there's one thing I want to add about the Truth Social merger. Citizens for Ethics and Responsibility in Washington, otherwise known as CREW, they pointed out earlier that the SPAC that's merging with True Social is Susquehanna International Group LLP, which was co-founded by GOP mega donor Jeffrey Yass. Some people might know that name as helping try to shape the outcome of different elections in Pennsylvania. And right now, he is supporting a super PAC that is trying to stop Summer Lee in her primary. This is the same guy who is spending big to try to stop Summer Lee in the Democratic primary. So when we talk about money in politics, we talk about how these people have influence. This is somebody who's partnering with Trump on Truth Social and simultaneously trying to support a moderate Democrat in the primary. So a perfect example and yet another example of why we need to get big money out of politics.
Okay, last couple of things then. First of all, the lien on the property solves the issue that Trey has legitimately. So you don't want to have different rules for Trump in either direction, where he's above the law or below the law. So if you put the liens on, he can't get away with it, but it doesn't sell his properties right away. Secondly, on Jeff Yass, there's a great point by Jordan. And here goes Yass Queen again. Because remember, he's the guy who owns 15% of TikTok. And that's why Donald Trump switched his position on TikTok, because it turns out Yass was going to try to funnel him a gigantic amount of money that, not for his campaign, that he could put in his pocket through the SPAC. Okay, now the last thing on the SPAC, the company, the Trump media play. Yeah, sure. I was one, and Jordan, you solved that for me. Because I was like, look, there's only one problem with this stock, which is why would anybody that's an investor put up money up front? No, like they already have a category for this type of stock. You know what it's called? It's the greater fool theory. Like that's why banks, you know, to answer Trey's question, and why would banks value it at this money? Well, they're using the greater fool theory that it's going to get really overinflated in the beginning because people are going to buy thinking there are greater fools than me and they'll buy it at an even higher price and then I'll dump, right? But the whole thing is predicated on everyone dumping the stock. And the only person who loses in that scenario is that shareholder. But if that shareholder that put the original investment in is Jeff Yass, And what he's getting in return is not shutting down TikTok, and he has a ton more money in TikTok. Now it all makes sense. So Yaz will probably lose money on this. Trump will come out, you know, even. He probably won't make money, but he didn't put any money in. But everyone who buys the stock, my guess, and it's an educated guess, is that almost everyone who buys the stock will lose. And that's how this will play out.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.